This week's episode is all about electric motors, and in that we mean electric motors that are there to propel the average size dinghy. So we're classifying that as something which is battery, leg and motor inclusive as one part. So we've come to Boot Düsseldorf to show you exactly what's on offer for you. And stick around to the end of the video. We've got a little table there presented for you, which is a comparison table, so you can check out the differences between all the brands and everything that's on offer. So let's get cracking. All right, to start it off, what could be better than using the originals themselves? Torqeedo started in 2005 with a remarkable piece of kit, and they've come a long way since there. This is their current travel model. She's 17 kilos, and she's available in all leg lengths, of which you can adapt the same leg. Basically, we just change out this orange piece here, and that allows us to drop the leg for your suit, well, whatever your suit is to. Now, other things we've got here, the prop is good. Props are a nice setup. What they've thought about there is you can buy this prop with various different sizes to adjust for your needs for your boat. Regarding innovation, she's IP67, so she's completely waterproof. You can throw her in the lake and pick her back out, or in the sea. The battery, super easy to remove. You just pick it up. She goes all the way up and comes out. Really, really simple. All the way in, back down, pop the lock pin in. It's really easy. The tiller control, she comes out the same. So this means that the whole thing for packaging and moving around is so easy, so light. Simple twist throttle, and then on top of that, a GPS unit located in the machine. This is giving you speed. It's also giving you battery life and also your engine temperature. Let's put it back together. All in all, really nice product from the guys who've been doing it for a long time. All right, so one other thing with Torqeedo, we're not entirely sure what is wrapped up in this polythene here, but let's just say I have a feeling it could be another motor for dinghies. So keep an eye on what they're doing. Who knows? All right, next we've got up is Aquamot with their Trend 1.8 motor. This is a cool motor. It is basically a 5.56 horsepower equivalent. So quite a meaty machine, actually. She weighs around 24 kilos, but she's only, I think, 16 when you take the battery off. Battery comes off very simply. This can be charged through here, so it's independently chargeable. You can charge this through their own solar power system, or you can charge it through an AC outlet of 110 or 230. So the props are available in three or four different sizes, and it's a variable speed motor. That's a good thing. We've got on the top the same sort of LCD that we come to expect from most machines. This one gives us the time running left on it, and it also gives us the battery status. Simple, straightforward tiller, turns around. This is also adjustable. It's a pretty cool piece of kit. And one thing's for sure, being able to charge it with solar is nice, but also having that little bit of extra power with an integrated battery may be the answer that many people are looking for. All right, next up we've got Parsun. This brand's a Chinese brand, more often known for their four-stroke engines, and this is their first offering to the electric market. So it's pretty much standard as far as things go. Engine's at the bottom of the motor. It's in line, so no gearbox. She's got a removable battery, which can be charged off the unit. And we've got a lovely screen here, which has given us how much time we've got left in the battery and our speed. And what's becoming par for the course, really, is a magnetic kill switch. Throttle, really simple system. We take the tiller, give her a little pull, and that drops down like so. IP67 connection, so that basically means she's completely waterproof. You can throw her in the lake or the sea. It's a common part these days, I think, though. Battery comes off like that. Really small footprint, easy to pack away. She's 10 kilos in the weight here, and she's 10 kilos here, which means the whole unit. Oh, that's the thing about being so clever and remember. 20 kilos, but really simple to put together, really simple to use. 1 kilowatt motor, so that's the equivalent of about 3 horsepower. And is that ready to go? I really like it. I think it's a good system. All right, so we're now at ePropulsion on this, and we have Steve with us. He's going to tell us a little bit about ePropulsion and their Spirit 1 Plus, which to me basically marks the evolution of the electric engine as we know it.
So this is the ePropulsion Spirit 1 Plus. This is the second generation of this motor. And the advantages of this motor is, of course, the motor is at the bottom in the Torqeedo, which is forward of the propeller. So it is a direct drive system, so there is no gearbox, and there is no water cooling, and typically these are the bits that cause problems in a petrol motor. The other advantage, of course, is the power supply. The battery on top is that simple to lift off, 8.5 kilograms, and then you're left with 10.5 kilograms of motor and shaft. And the simplest way to do that is quite simply to pull the, and that folds away neatly for stowage. It literally takes seconds. Pop it back out, pop the battery on, and off you go. The motor is, as I said, 1,000 watts, and the battery is 1,276 watts. So if you went full throttle, then you would have 1 hour and 15 minutes. But the reality is this would push up to 1.5 tons, but it's normally used on a small tender, typical application where you'd only use 300 or 400 watts of input power. So in that case, you've got 4 or 5 hours or 10 or 12 miles out of one charge. No noise, no smell, no servicing, no vibration, no winterizing, no rope to pull. Why wouldn't you? Is that enough?
I think it's pretty good.
Okay, yeah.
And so just another thing is, we know that the ePropulsion battery actually floats. So if you're clumsy like me, it's not the end of the world, right? What these guys have actually got on their stand as well, they have a live battery floating. They have another one in the ward, which we'll show you. But I think what's more important, which really helps push the revolution of electric, is a comparison to a four-stroke outboard, which has been running for 20 minutes in the clean water that these two electric motors are in. So when you see that, it might start making you think four strokes are just not as clean as what we think. All right, thanks, Steve.
Welcome.
Cheers.
Thank you very much. All right, so we're with Temo now, and we reckon that Temo is probably the most innovative company in outboards at the moment, and that's what's brought us here. This is Letitia, and she's going to run Hello. Us through some of the cool things that are going on with their product. So this is the first product I think you guys brought to the market?
Yes, absolutely. The first that we launched more than 2 years ago now. It's an innovative product. It's very light, 5 kilos weight. It's very easy to install, and it's adapted for light boats such as dinghies up to 2.6 meters, light sailing boats, canoe. So it's very practical.
And the battery is integral in this.
It's inside the gray tube.
So
yes.
It's kind of that small. You can tie it under your guardrails and kind of forget about it. And everything's adjustable.
Yes, telescopic tube.
It's a really nice piece of kit, really worth a look at. But that's not where Temo finished. They've now brought out their new model, which is the
Temo 1000.
Temo 1000.
1000 watts. So this one is the double power from the first one. It will propel sailing boats of more than 1 ton or big tenders. So it's quite innovative as well. The differences with what is existing on the market now is the first you can choose the height of the shaft.
Yeah, so all shaft lengths are in one model. So
yes.
We just undo this and move it up and down. I mean, it's super.
To adapt it perfectly to your boat. The battery is very easily removable, more resistant. So easily removable, easy to install as well, such as the first one. So you have this bracket, and it's 360 degrees. You can install your engine while you are inside your boat, and then you just turn it very easily, like that.
So it's super simple. It's kind of engineering at its best. Engineering should be simple and easy to understand. And it's that simple. The tiller as well, it just pops out. So it's everything's enclosed. You haven't got parts to come off and drop. I think it's a really, really good system, and that's why it's our top pick for an engine. And the display that we have here, although this is a bit smaller than what else may be on the market. What does it display?
It will enable to check the battery level in percent. We are working on a new display that will really enable to have the best experience possible while using the outboard.
Okay, so kind of equivalent to a 3-horsepower petrol engine, yes. Let's say, but nowhere near the weight, nowhere near the faff, and you don't have to service it. So I think really, really a nice product that these guys have brought to the market. And yeah, definitely Temo's a brand to be looking at in the future. Leticia, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Cheers.
So it's clear to see that the electric revolution is starting. You know, there's almost more electric motors at the show. Well, there's definitely more electric motors at the show than there are like combustion engines. However, the electric tender engine has definitely taken off now. I think that's where it's progressing first. That's why we made this video. So hopefully there's a lot of you guys thinking about going electric. It's certainly better for the environment. Just check out that little bit from ePropulsion. It's insane the difference between internal combustion and electric as to the effect of the environment. Anyhow, as promised, that table's coming up right now. That'll be next, so hope that's useful for you guys. And let's hope we see a lot more of you guys belting around the anchorages on electric. So, thanks for watching the video. Stick around and watch the next few. It's all about innovation, technology, and sustainability.